Hello students, today we'll discuss about total internal reflections. Let us understand the concept of TIR and some of its applications. Students, let's start with total internal reflection. When light travels from a denser medium to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal, and if you keep on increasing the angle of incidence in the denser medium, then it bends still more towards the base or more away from the normal. So it bends more towards the base, and at a certain angle of incidence in the denser medium, the ray moves along the surface. That angle is 90 degree, and the angle of incidence in the denser medium which creates this refraction angle 90 degree is called as critical angle. That means if I have, this is the boundary interface which separates two media. One is here, this is the source of light, this is denser medium. And that above it is rarer medium. Now we'll consider a point source of light here and see if it moves in all possible directions, what will happen, how it comes out, or whether it comes out or doesn't come out in the other medium. This is the point source of light. Now I'll consider this way. I'm considering the only the refracted part of the ray. This is the incident ray, and because this is the normal, this will go undeviated, go straight, and that goes to the other side without any deviation. And this ray which strikes this interface at certain angle, because this is the normal, at certain angle of incidence, say I, it should have gone straight, the ray should have gone straight, but it will bend away from the normal. So instead of going in this direction, it will bend away from the normal like that. This is how it will come out in rarer medium. If I still go for more angle of incidence from here to here, I am keeping the angle of incidence increasing. Suppose this is a 1, this is the 2. In each time I'm increasing the angle of incidence in the denser medium, and this is the normal, and instead of going straight, it will bend still away from the normal. So you can see that as I keep on increasing the angle of incidence in the denser medium, the angle of refraction in the rarer medium is also increasing, because this is the angle of refraction R1 say, this is the angle of refraction in the second case R2 say. So as I consider another ray like that, at certain angle of incidence, so this ray in the refraction side, in the rarer medium, initially it goes straight, then it starts bending like that. You can see here, bending, more bending, and a time will come at a particular angle of incidence. Suppose that angle of incidence I call is CIC. At a particular angle of incidence in the denser medium, the refracted ray will not come out in this side, it moves along the surface. So you can see here, only if you see the refracted ray, initially it was like this, then it bends more clockwise, then more clockwise, now it is along the surface. So its journey from this vertical ray to this horizontal ray, the rotation is like that. So the ray will rotate like this, from vertical to along the surface, the ray gradually, the refracted ray gradually moves and moves. Now it grazes the surface. It grazes, moves along the interface. So therefore, this angle, which is responsible for this R to be, in this case, the R is 90 degree, because the angle of refraction when the ray grazes the surface is 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree, and the angle of incidence which is responsible for this is called critical angle. So this IC is called critical angle. Then first, what is a critical angle? Critical angle is that angle in the denser medium corresponding to which the refracted ray moves along the surface. That means the angle of refraction becomes 90 degree. Now the question comes about total internal reflections. That means if I go beyond that, if I still increase the angle of incidence, that means I have to strike the ray away from this line somewhere here, then what will happen? If I let the ray strike away from here, then what will happen? Here, this angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle. If this is greater than that, then this ray will follow the law of reflection. This refracted ray, which was moving along the surface, now will move down into the same medium. So light moving from denser medium comes back to the same medium, and for this acts like a mirror, this surface acts like a mirror, this rarer medium acts like a mirror for this case, and it will act like a mirror only when the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle. You can see here the angle of incidence. Suppose this angle of incidence is 45. If the ray strikes beyond that, this angle will be definitely more than this, and in that case it will follow the law of reflection. So this ray is reflected back. So no ray is escaping to the rarer medium. So therefore this is called total internal reflection. One more thing is that why it is called total internal reflection, why it is not called internal reflection? Because internal reflection was taking place earlier also. Let me explain to you this, that in this case this is refracted and some part is reflected back also. Here also it follows laws of reflection. Some part is refracted, some part is reflected. Some part is refracted, some part is reflected. This angle is angle of incidence and that is angle of reflection. So reflection was taking place both in all the cases along with the refraction. But here this is also, that is when the critical angle, the ray grazes the surface, but that reflected part of the ray was coming in. But beyond this reflected part also coming in, and the ray which was moving to the rarer medium also coming in. So here the total internal reflection takes place. This total internal reflection is due to the reflected part of the wave light which is actually taking place, and also the ray which is going outside also getting reflected back. That means no part of the light is going out. When there is no refraction, then in that case that reflection is called total internal reflection. Otherwise, in all the cases, the reflection was taking place. So this is the case when the refracted ray is also reflected back. That is known as total internal reflection. So what will happen? So we have to write the condition. So the condition of total internal reflection is, there are two conditions, 1 and 2, that will write. One is that This is the first condition. The ray must move from denser medium to rarer medium. Second condition is that the angle of incidence in the denser medium should be greater than the critical angle. If these two conditions are met, then PIR will take place. For example, if you take the to understand the concept of TIR, you must know for a given set of pair of media, we must know about the critical angle. For example, in case of air and glass, so the critical angle of glass is around 42 degrees. So that means in a glass, if I incident the ray, if the ray comes out from the glass to air and if the angle of incidence in the denser medium is greater than 45, the ray will not come out. Okay, what is the meaning of that? Suppose that this is a glass slab. Suppose that there is a bulb here, LED bulb inside the glass, and it moves like that in such a way that it is air outside. This is glass, this is air, and for glass of refractive index mu of glass is suppose 3/2, then I know that for critical angle, to find critical angle, sine of C is 1 upon mu, that is 2/3, putting this value here. So C is sine inverse 2/3, which is approximately equal to 42 degrees. That means if the critical angle is known to me, if this angle of incidence in the denser medium, because this is denser, this is air, it has to come out. If this angle is suppose 45 degree, then this angle of incidence is greater than my critical angle C, that is 45 degree is greater than 42 degree. So therefore, this ray will not come out because this angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. This condition is satisfied. The angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, then there is no refraction, the ray will not come out, only there will be reflection. So whatever is the angle 45, with the same angle 45, this will come inside. So if a bulb is lit inside the glass slab, and if the ray, all those rays striking, of if a ray of light is allowed to fall, because light will come in all directions, that will come out. But rays that are striking at an angle of 45 degree will be reflected back. Okay, that means a ray striking at 45 degree will be reflected back. No light will come out in air. Okay, so this is the concept of total internal reflections. Okay, thank you.